we've got a few options when developing on the Raspberry Pi. We can connect a mouse, keyboard, and a monitor and treat it like a desktop computer. This is a great option, but it's not always very convenient. First off, you need a spare mouse, a spare keyboard, and a spare monitor. And you need the Raspberry Pi close enough that you can plug all this together. This Raspberry Pi is part of my Wordle solving robot, and it's connected to my 3D printer. I could plug everything into it, but it's a bit of a pain, and I'd probably end up ripping the sockets off the board. If you don't have these spare peripherals, you can set up the Pi in a headless way and connect to it via SSH. Once you've connected, then you've got access to Vim and Nano. I'm quite used to using these for making quick edits, but it's not the most friendly of editors to use. There are of course more fully functional editors that you can use from the command line. Emacs is particularly powerful. Another option, once we've got our headless Pi up and running and connected to our network, is to use VNC. This is quite nice, and we get access to the Pi's desktop environment. We can then install an IDE like VSCode and crack on with our development. This last option is nice, but it's still a bit annoying to use, and we need to have a desktop environment installed and running on our Pi. In this video, I'm going to present a much nicer alternative that lets you run VSCode as an IDE without needing to use VNC to connect to the Pi's desktop. But first, a quick plug for the channel sponsor, PCBWay. Do you like PCBs? Do you want to make a PCB in a weird and wacky colour like purple? Maybe you'd like a flexible PCB. Or maybe you'd like someone to do some CNC work for you. Check out the link to PCBWay in the description. So, first off, we'll do a headless setup of our Pi. This is now trivially easy with the Pi Imager app, as we can now access the advanced options using this cogwheel icon. This lets us set up the hostname, turn on SSH, set the username and password, and add the Wi-Fi credentials. When we boot the Pi from the SD card, everything will be set up nicely for us. Now for the magic part of the video. I'm going to open up VS Code on my desktop computer and install the Remote Development Extension Pack. With this installed, we now get this extra button in the bottom left of the window. If we click on this button, we get an option to connect to a host. We just enter the same thing we would use to connect via SSH. In my case, the user is Pi, and I set up the machine to have a host name Wordle, so I just enter Pi at Wordle, and then we enter our password. VS Code will install the VS Code server on the Pi, and we're good to go. I'm going to use my Wordle solving robot code as a demonstration project, so I'll need to clone it from GitHub. We can use the clone from Git option in VS Code to do this for us, and then we just open up the folder that has been cloned. I've got an additional extension that I want to install into my remote environment. This is the Python project, so I want to install the Python extension. This will also install the extensions for running Jupyter Notebooks. We're now ready to finish setting up our project on the Pi. I'll open up a new terminal in VS Code. This automatically opens up a terminal on our Pi in the correct folder, and I'll just follow the instructions in my README file. There are some native dependencies that I'll need to install, so we'll kick that off first. With that done, we can install our Python dependencies. The first thing I'll do is create a virtual environment. This keeps our Python dependencies nice and local to our project. VS Code should automatically detect that we have a virtual environment and will switch to using it for Python. We then activate this environment in the terminal and install all our Python dependencies. This takes quite a while as we want Jupyter Notebooks, OpenCV, and support for PyCamera. We're now ready to run our code. I'll open up the Jupyter Notebook that does the image processing for the Wordle robot. We can access the Pi's camera directly and read images straight from it, as all our code is running on the Pi. We can step through each of our notebook cells and run them. And what's more, we can even debug the code and see what's going on. This is a really nice way of developing code on the Pi. We've got access to all the Pi's hardware, so we know immediately if our code will work or not. There are, as always, some limitations. There's no support for ARMv6, so you can't use this on a Pi Zero. But other than that, it works really well. So, thanks for watching. I hope this was a useful and interesting video. I'll see you all soon.